Hi, my name is Ko, and I'm with the Institute of Electronics at Graz, University of Technology. In this very short clip, I would like to demonstrate a typical EMC problem. Today, I've brought this PCB with me. On the left side, you can see a measuring bridge. So one of those resistances could be a strain gauge strip, for instance. And we're interested in measuring the voltage between the two midpoints. And we're conducting that voltage here, up to here, where the signal sees an operational amplifier. And we're amplifying that signal by 25. And what we can see here on the scope is now the amplified signal of the voltage between the two midpoints here. On the bottom side here, I have placed another circuitry, which is the exact same circuitry as here on top, with only one difference, that we are using here another operational amplifier. Here on the yellow labeled place, we're going to place an old mobile phone here. And we are interested in disturbing now the conducting signal by a mobile phone. So let me redraw that layout in a schematic. So let's start with that measuring bridge here on the left. So we have here a measuring bridge, and we are interested in measuring the voltage difference between the two midpoints, so at this voltage here. And this is now going through a long wire, so this is now this long connection here, and here we have our operational amplifier. So here our signal comes to an operational amplifier, so first here to a buffer structure. So this is here just a buffer. And then here to another op-amp where we are setting the amplification by those two resistors here. And if we are now choosing here 100 ohms, and here 2400 ohms, then we will achieve an amplification of the factor 25, because this is here a non-inverting structure. And here on end, we will connect our scope. And you can see here that the input signal here sees a high impedance, input impedance on both sides. So this is a way to build a cheap instrumentation amplifier, so that we have a high input impedance for both inputs. And then here we are connecting here a wire to VDD, and here another wire here to ground. So also here, the operational amplifiers are powered up. And we are also using here some decoupling capacitors. We have here our measuring bridge. So this can be a strain gauge, for instance. And here, the differential voltage, that is what we are interested in. And we are measuring here with the scope the amplified signal of that differential voltage here. So the scope shows us the amplified value of the differential voltage of our measuring bridge. And by adjusting one of those resistances, we can also adjust the seen output value here. There's another component here. This is this device here. So this is just a speaker that we can hear in a few seconds, what I would like to show you now. In normal conditions, the circuit here behaves like it should. But what happens if I recall the phone here? So what happens if the phone is here receiving and sending some GSM signals? So let's make a short call. And you may remember that annoying sound now. You can now see here on the scope that we are measuring some disturbances here. So let's try to catch one of those. Yes, now here we have one. The task of an EMC engineer is now to get rid of those EMC problems here. And how can we solve this problem now? So there are, as usual, several possibilities to solve a problem. One obvious way would be to place some filters here in front of our operational amplifier input. Another way could be to use another operational amplifier which is more robust against RF emissions, so that the top operational amplifier may be more susceptible against electromagnetic emissions compared to the operational amplifier on the bottom here. And we can check this here by switching the operational amplifier now and make another call. And you will see and you will hear nothing. Because the second operational amplifier here, let's place it here to make a fair comparison. And now we won't see any disturbance signal here. And this is just by using a more robust operational amplifier. Okay then, I hope you've liked the short demonstration of a typical EMC problem and that you have learned something new. But anyways, thanks for watching.